And welcome back, one and all, to youtube.com/Bradley Hall maintaining adequate levels of hydration.com. Right, so on this channel, we do spend a lot of time being cynical, poking fun at things, cliche things, cringy things, all of that good stuff, you know? But I thought today, maybe we'll take a break from that for once and actually spend some time appreciating some proper good art. I noticed that YouTube seems to be lacking some sort of comprehensive top 10 list of greatest metal music videos or something along those lines. So why not do one of those, I thought. At first, this seemed like a pretty monumental task, so I thought the best thing to do would be to split the list up into categories, just like the Oscars, but with less glitz and glam and no celebrities and hairier and longer toenails. So these five categories are best animated videos, best comedic videos, best emotional videos, best shocking videos, and best videos with very high production value. Just like this YouTube channel. As for how I chose my picks, I sort of went with a 50-50 approach of like half community consensus on like what the best ones are, and half what my personal opinion is. I know nobody cares, but I wanted to do it like that anyway. But just before we start, I want you to write down below in the comments your favorite metal music videos. Go on, I can wait. Are you ready? Let's do this. Portal are an experimental death metal band from Australia, who I guess look a little bit like Ghost, but actually sound like what you'd expect Ghost to sound like. I'd say they're one of the few bands who actually succeed in sounding genuinely fucking evil, and this music video for their song Curtain is certainly no exception. Based off of the exceedingly grim poem The Conqueror Worm by Edgar Allan Poe, this video uses a combination of animation and puppetry to create a series of haunting scenes that really feel like they've been plucked directly out of your nightmares. Some of my favourite scenes include this amazing establishing shot of the theatre, where we see a giant musical contraption rising up to the stage, featuring some proper spooky violinists with loads of bees on their face or something, I don't know. I also particularly love this eerie living room set featuring a giant creepy eyeball and protruding slimy hand. All in all, a spectacular video that you definitely don't want to be watching before beddy buys. Right, so as many of you know, I'm not exactly the biggest Tool fan in the world. But that being said, it's impossible to deny that they've made some really masterful music videos. Now I know that many Tool diehards' top pick is usually Schism, but in my opinion the visuals of that video haven't aged too well, and there are some scenes that are kind of unintentionally funny. For me personally, the real gem is the video for their 1993 song Sober. Directed by Fred Sturr, the video is filmed entirely with stop-motion animation and follows the antics of a little deformed humanoid lad in his magic box. The animation is absolutely gorgeous and has that real cool grimy 90s quality to it. I always tend to prefer stop-motion and cartoon animation over CGI, as it has a more timeless quality to it and ages far better. I mean, look at the CGI animation in the video to Iron Maiden's Angel and the Gambler, which came out 5 years later. Eesh. Anyway, I'm not entirely sure what the meaning behind Sober's video is, perhaps something about the hopelessness of addiction, but the magic really is in the mystery, and the journey it takes you on is utterly mesmerizing and powerful, if not depressing as fuck. You might want to stick on a Disney movie after these last two videos or something. So the first pick for this category was a pretty obvious one. The undisputed king of comedic metal music videos, Bewitched by Candlemass. What's funny about this video is that people with an undeveloped sense of humour often label it as cringe, but it's ridiculously evident that it was filmed in a completely tongue-in-cheek nature and entirely self-aware. There are so many things to love about this video. The legendary opening of the vocalist bursting out of the coffin, the amazing dance that puts Michael Jackson's Thriller to shame, the hilarious bystander shots, the unnecessarily dramatic performances. I love it all! The absolutely disgusting film quality and extremely DIY aesthetic definitely adds to the charm of the video too. I think if a band tried to do something similar today with modern technology, it just wouldn't have that same effect. But that being said, Messiah's delivery is certainly the star of this video and is what makes it so memorable. If he didn't put as much conviction into his performance as he did, then yes, I guess the result may have been cringy and laughable for the wrong reasons.
So it just goes to show that Candlemass's Bewitched is living proof that you can produce a truly legendary video on a non-existent budget. All you need is a personality as big as Messiah's hair. So the other pick for this category wasn't such an easy one to make, as there were a couple of other hot contenders. But in the end, I feel that the video for Meshuggah's New Millennium Cyanide Christ is the deserving winner. There's not really much to talk about with this video, as it's literally just the band air guitaring along to the song on their tour bus. But, as with the Candlemass video, the band does it with enough conviction and panache to make it a strangely compelling watch, especially the vocalist who's giving as much energy as he would do on stage while screaming into a goddamn pencil. What's more, it's actually surprisingly well filmed and edited, considering the confines of what they were working with on the set there. I especially love the opening shot looking into the bus. It always cracks me up. I think another thing that makes it such an entertaining watch is the contrast between how ridiculously complicated the music is and how simplistic the video is. Oh, and the shades, of course. Probably the most famous music video in this entire list, Metallica's One has gone down in history as one of metal's greatest and most poignant videos. Pretty impressive when you consider it was the first music video the band released thus far in their career. It's deadly simple in concept, predominantly featuring the band playing through the song in an empty warehouse with dramatic lighting and ceiling fans. What makes the video especially effective, however, is the use of movie clips spliced into the performance, reinforcing the grim narrative being told. The clips come from the 1971 film Johnny Got His Gun, which has a very similar theme to the song's lyrics, telling the story of a soldier who loses all of his limbs, eyes, ears, mouth, and nose in battle, rendering him a prisoner in his own body. And you thought you were having a bad day? Jeez! The way the music and narrative gradually build up together throughout the video is perfect, right up until the heartbreaking climax where the soldier's begging for death! Despite Johnny Got His Gun being 50 years old now, the visuals of the maimed soldier are still incredibly harrowing and really add an extra layer of emotional gravity to the song's lyrics. The most haunting scene, though, in my opinion, is right at the end, where a group of workers are giving what I presume is some sort of festive toast, and the singing fades into a shot of the soldier in his bed, doomed to be trapped in his body for the rest of his life. Now, from one of the oldest videos on the list to the newest, there was no doubt in my mind that Constance by Spirit Box would take this spot. Spirit Box are a textbook example of how to run a band in the current year. They recognize how absolutely integral music videos are in the age of YouTube, and how a good one can really help carry a song above and beyond. What I like about Spirit Box is that their music actually makes you feel something, which, let's be honest, is pretty rare in the sterile, overpopulated world of modern metalcore. Now, this music video turns up the emotion dial to 11, portraying a family struggling with what I assume is the onset of dementia in the grandmother figure. We see from her perspective as the faces of her loved ones start to blur and become less familiar, and how this seemingly terrifies her. The video itself is beautifully shot and utilizes some pretty creative camera work to convey the grandmother's point of view. And I especially love the single shots of the band members swathed in some gorgeous natural-looking light. Like all of the other videos on this list, Constance just takes a very simple idea but executes it flawlessly, and is a reminder that oftentimes the darkest and scariest subject matter is the everyday shit that life throws at you. So to kick things off in this category is the OG of shocking extreme metal music videos, From the Cradle to Enslave by Cradle of Filth. The video is a classic tour de force in 90s B-movie style horror, taking place in a spooky mansion populated by a deformed Lovecraftian inhabitant, not to be confused with the band, mind you. As the song progresses, each member of the band stars in their own little segue of them being tortured or mutilated in some form or another. The gory scenes aren't as full-on as what we're used to these days, but they're presented in a sort of fantastical manner which adds to the B-movie aesthetic and doesn't make the video look dated. Not to mention there's also copious amounts of full-on nudity. It's daft, campy, gory as fuck, and I bloody love it, though I still maintain that the most disturbing thing about the video is Danny's top. I think it's fair to say that no list of shocking music videos would be complete without cattle decapitations, forced gender reassignment. The video isn't even that old, but it seems to have already attained legendary status for its insanely graphic content. I know strong adjectives like insane are thrown around willy-nilly these days, but I'm really not understating it this time, yeah? Absolutely do not watch this video if you're in any way squeamish, or you will instantly regret it, I promise you. Despite being completely grossed out on the face of it, the song does actually hold a poignant message in regards to gender dysphoria and trans rights. So the concept of the song does become more interesting after knowing this, but yeah, stay away from this one unless you're a sick bastard like me, and enjoy some good old splattery carnage. When I asked you guys a while ago for your top music video picks, Deutschland by Rammstein was by far the most common choice, and for good reason too, I think. This absolute juggernaut of a music video has more production value than some feature-length movies I've seen in recent years, and it is truly a spectacle to behold. Deutschland tells the history of, well, unsurprisingly, Germany, by cutting between different periods of time and historical events, sometimes explicitly and other times through metaphors. I honestly have no bloody idea what's going on throughout the majority of its 7-minute runtime, but damn, is it a fun ride. All of the various time periods and scenes are presented immaculately with super vibrant set design and visuals, my favourite of which being the band portrayed as monks whilst eating a load of sausages or something on top of the Germania character. I don't know what it's meant to represent, but it looks pretty cool. I feel like if you're keyed up on your German history, then there's probably a ton of rewatchability to be had and loads of Easter eggs to find. Our last music video of this list brings us from Germany to Poland with Behemoth's Blow Your Trumpets, Gabriel. Now, I've got to admit, at first I dismissed Behemoth's later music videos as, like, pretentious hipster bollocks. And even though I still kind of think that, I've really grown to enjoy them and can't deny that some of the imagery in their works is really freaking awesome. The imagery in the scenes where the woman's getting converted, or whatever the hell's going on, I don't know, is really some of the best I've seen in a music video. Especially the shots of the angel blowing the trumpet along with the song's outro. Exceptionally sick stuff. So yeah, the whole ordeal is incredibly up its own bum and the definition of style over substance, but damn, is it fucking cool.
Well guys, what did you think of my picks? Agree?
Disagree?
Please do let me know what you thought below in the comments, and don't forget to leave the video a big old girthy thumbs up.
And do a bit of the old that maybe, you know, yeah? Bit of the old that.
Thank you very much guys, love each and every one of you, and I will see you very soon.